Peace, peace. Yeah, I got cut off by my daughter over there playing. But yeah, like I said, man, I think, you know, I could feel it, man. Any fan, man, or anyone looking from the outside in can sense the hate, man. Now, I know Sherm the Worm Lake, a lot of these other dudes, man, they could say that they wasn't hating on P, right? And, you know, they feel that way, man. It might, you know, they might feel that it's really true, but a lot of times, man, you know, we let our intelligence get dulled down and we could start hating on someone and don't even know it, man. P brought a lot of attention, like a brother in the comment section was saying that P brought a lot of attention, P brought a lot of energy, a lot of, you know, he put the spotlight on Queensbridge, man. Nas did, of course, Mobb Deep. Before then, MC Shan, but what I'm saying, it was a different type of attention, a different type of energy. You know what I'm saying? P repped, man, come on, man. P repped Queensbridge the same way you would hear Big Pun, God Bless the Dead, screaming Terror Squad every single, almost maybe three, four times a bar, man. Now, they say, can Prodigy be considered top five in Queensbridge? Of course he could, because, you know, he put in work in hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? Now, it comes to the streets. Can Prodigy be top five in the streets of Queensbridge? Then, you know, I mean, based on what I know, I would say no. You know, then you would have maybe cats like, you know, you got Sherman Adams, you know, Lake, you know, cats like Capone, and, you know, whatever the politics is with that, then maybe, yeah, that's correct. They might be top five. You know, you got them gangster cats. But P was definitely top five within Queensbridge rap. Come on, man. And I'm glad that Nas, within that song, he built on that. You know, he built on how much Prodigy it was loved and how much he's missed today and how much he means to Queensbridge. So, the brothers who did that, I don't know who did that to the mural and all of that, but whoever did that, man, you know, that was foul, and I think it was something personal. They say it was street politics. And, hey, I can understand that. You know what I mean? It was street politics. That's something that went on with them. It's none of my business, really. The only reason, you know, we know about it and we're speaking about it is because dudes in the street mentioned it. P came out with the book. And then, you know, now they're doing interviews. Everybody's speaking about it, Instagram posts and things like that. So they put people in the business. People know the business now. And, you know, that's why people are speaking about it and whatnot. But my opinion with the mural, I believe that, yeah, it should be there, you know, alongside Nas, alongside Traj, and then I know the brother Sherman Adams, he mentioned that, I think he said Spank and some of the other brothers, Ill Will should be up there, right? Okay, of course, I agree, but why ain't nobody pressing the issue? They pressed the issue with Prodigies to be up there, and they did it, so why someone don't put out the call right now? Yo, put Ill Will up there tomorrow. Put, you know what I mean? So, to me, it sounded like an excuse. Sounded like an excuse to get at Prodigy, to try to extort Prodigy. Prodigy seemed like a real good dude. To me, do he see? You know, he knew a lot of street dudes that probably would get down for him. You know, whether he had to pay him or not, I don't really know how close he was like that with them. You know what I mean? But P, the way he moved and everything, you know, he seemed like a very cool dude. He seemed intelligent. And, you know, I think he made a mistake trying to befriend the wrong people, bring the wrong people into his life. Like with me, check this out, right? If I go to any new neighborhood, I go to anybody's neighborhood, the first thing I do is I watch how the people within that neighborhood treat each other. Now, check it. Just because they treat each other bad don't mean that they're going to treat you bad. Sometimes they treat you better than they treat the people in their neighborhood. But what I'm saying is I pay attention to how people treat each other. Why? Because eventually, they will treat you the same way or either worse. Not in the beginning. So I think P, you know, he was trying to befriend these cats. Man, P, to me, he rapped street. I don't really think he was out there like that, but he rapped street. He seemed like he was attracted to street dudes. And I think that he tried to befriend these cats, man. Sherman the Worm, Lake, you know, these dudes' names is buzzing in the street, it's holding weight. You know, their names is popping off. You know what I'm saying? You hearing, these cats getting it in. So I think P was attracted to gangsters, man. I think he liked gangsters. His pops was a gangster. You know what I'm saying? I think P had a gangster mentality, a gangster mind. I mean, not just a gangster mind, more than that, but he was good, man. The brother could probably write a movie on some gangster tip. And so I think he tried to befriend these cats, man. And certain people, you're just not going to mix with. Just not gonna mix with, man. That's why I try not to make promises. Make promises to people, and sometimes the promise could fall through. You know, it could fall through, and it's not your fault. But these cats will make it your fault. Trust me. So you got some of these street dudes that you just can't. You can't be friends with. You could barely associate yourself with them, or even conversate with them. Some of these cats, man. But you know, shout out to Lake and all of them cats in Queensbridge. Hopefully, you know, they can get it together, man, and squash whatever type of beef they got going on, because Queensbridge makes some of the best music to me, just like the brothers out in Philly is doing it. They make some really good music. Brooklyn, all over, really, but you got Queens make some of the best music. They stand out, just like you got Philly make some of the best music. Them brothers stand out. So, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think Prodigy's mural should have stood up. You know, doing what they did to it was kind of fat. It was foul, you know what I mean? Because if it was anyone else, so I understand it was about the book and everything like that, street politics, Queensbridge politics. And I guess that's that. Ain't nobody saying nothing. Ain't nobody doing nothing. They took it down, you know, to... probably dead that negative energy. And you know, why keep putting it up if somebody's gonna take the energy to keep destroying it? And these people come, you know, it costs money and time, so I understand. So I guess that's what Nas was talking about in, you know, Queensbridge politics.